Hi, this is Johannes with Glassbox, and in this video we are going to take a look at setting up and changing camera settings in DragonFly for Unreal Engine. You will find DragonFly's camera settings in the middle of the operator main panel. From here, we can change all the usual things that you would expect from a camera. For example, we can change the focal length, we can change the aperture, all within the limits of this particular lens. Speaking of lenses, of course, we can also swap out lenses. This is a 24-70. Maybe we want to go to a 30 prime, right? Let's go back to our zoom lens for the moment. We can also change the output format. This is 16:9. Maybe we want to use an IMAX sensor or a sensor on the other side of the size scale. Of course, we can also set up completely custom lenses and camera profiles. I'll get to that in a minute. There are some settings missing from this interface that you may expect from a camera, things like ISO settings, for example. That's because in Unreal Engine, your exposure by default is always going to be level. However, if you really want more control over exposure, go to DragonFly settings panel and switch exposure mode from Unreal settings, which is recommended usually, to physical simulation. And doing that, you can see that we have a couple more settings here now. We have ISO, shutter angle, and defilter. And if we move the f-stop, for example, you can see that these settings now also affect our exposure levels. So same for ND filter, of course. Notice how this scene isn't exposed super realistically at the moment. If you look at these settings, this is at ISO 12,800, f2.8, we would probably expect this scene to be brighter. That's because most Unreal Engine scenes aren't just lit realistically from the start. So if you are using this physical simulation for the exposure, then just be aware of that. There's ways to fix that. You could either go into the scene, edit your light sources, make them brighter, or you can adjust for that brightness difference, for example, by increasing the ISO value. A lot of the time though, you'll probably not be in physical simulation. So let's go back to the more basic Unreal settings here. And let's talk about the focus options that we have as well. By default, your focus method is going to be set to none. And for a lot of shots, when focus and depth of field aren't relevant, you can just leave this focus method at none. If you do want focus though, there's two options here. The most convenient one is tracking focus. Focus tracking does what it sounds like. It tracks focus to an object in your scene. So let's find one. I'm gonna scrub through our sequence here, and we can, for example, track focus to one of these robots that are coming out of this doorway here. Let's select it. All I have to do is click this picker icon here, select the robot, and then select which part of the robot I want to bind my focus to. Let's say to the head. And now DragonFly is going to track my focus distance to this actor. Exactly, you can actually see the focus distance in the HUD down here as well. And as I play back the sequence, you can see this focus distance continually changing. I can also visualize the focus distance by clicking this little icon, which will bring up a focus plane. You can see it cut right through the focus point there. And again, as I play this back, you'll see how this moves with the actor that we are tracking focus on. And lastly, if we simply want manual focus, we can do that as well. Select manual focus, and this allows us to simply pull focus. We can also hide this focus highlight plane again. We can, of course, also pull focus with other input methods. An easy way to do that is to bind focus pulling to a joystick, for example. You can do that in joysticks by setting up an axis binding and selecting focus distance. If you're interested in doing this, we have other videos diving deeper into joystick bindings.
Cool.
If you want to dive deeper with me into DragonFly's lens settings and lens simulation, we have a part two to this video. In that video, we'll look at setting up custom lens and camera profiles and at some awesome things like anamorphic lenses and lens distortions. But this was everything you need to know about getting started with lens settings in DragonFly for Unreal.